never meant to make you cry.
Yesterday we learned a song at school.
You learned a song at school? What song did you learn?
If you happen to know it.
Hey! If you happen to you know it, turn around, touch the ground, wiggle your bum, reach the stars. Is it that one? He needs to be sitting up. If he doesn't, he'll develop pneumonia. And with that amount of edema in the tissue, he needs repeat inflammatory markers and hourly OBS. When I come back, I want him sitting and nursed at 45 degrees.
Jack.
I don't care how busy it is up here today or how you need my help, I will be my regular granddad fix. Understood?
It's not me you need to worry about. Have you seen this?
Yeah, Mr. Spence told me.
Jay Naylor, as in Jack Naylor?
Yep.
Why is she listed as a patient?
Because she's donating one of her kidneys.
Jack Naylor? So why is she donating one of her kidneys to Paula Burrows in bed 7?
Because Paula Burrows is Miss Naylor's mother.
You're joking?
No. That's why Mr. Spence asked me to cover up here.
Why is she here working when she's being operated on this afternoon?
That I can't tell you. Why don't you ask her?
There's quite a lot of slough and much wider dehiscence. We need a back dressing to encourage some tissue granulation.
Okay.
Jack, I need to talk to you.
I'm busy. Can it wait?
No. You're having a kidney removed today. Why are you still at work?
I was on call last night. I stayed here, so I thought as I'm going to be here for the next 4 or 5 days, there wasn't much point in going home.
Are you still planning on going through with this?
Of course. HTA gave the go-ahead, my HLA typing and cross-matching's done, and my CT and MAG3 scan came back clean as a whistle.
Then you are on immediate bed rest.
Why? I'm fine. My serological tests show I'm, in fact, in perfect health. That is, until you remove one of my kidneys, then. Mm.
Are you nil by mouth?
Of course, since midnight.
Then stop working. You could jeopardize the treatment of one of your patients.
What do you want me to do? Sit around and read Heat magazine?
I want you to take up exactly what you are putting yourself through.
There. Done it.
Jack!
You come into my office. You sign those consent forms.
She doesn't look like someone who's about to donate a kidney.
I know.
And that doesn't bother you? I gather her relationship with her mother isn't exactly close.
Yeah, we talked for 20 years.
Look at Kitty Jennings' case notes.
Yeah, I'm just checking her barium followed through an X-ray.
Uh-huh. And I don't suppose that you're taking such an interest in her case all of a sudden would have anything to do with her mother.
She ambushed me in the lobby.
Well, I bet you hated that. She's
quite impressive.
Fiercely protective of her daughter.
She just wants what's best for her.
Mm-hmm. So you decided that you'd involve yourself in her case.
She tells me that you're going to do the bowel surgery via a keyhole procedure.
I think strictureplasty is the preferred course of treatment, yes.
Yeah, but Rick, I'm looking at the X-ray now, and it's like a herd of balloon animals in it. I mean, there's so many areas of narrowing and pinching, there's no way you can do it laparoscopically.
I disagree. She's only 15. I don't want her losing an excessive amount of bowel at this age. Her quality of life is going to be immensely improved.
Improved? How? By coming back here year after year to remove more tiny sections of bowel?
Keyhole offers minimal scarring, minimal recovery time.
All right, look, I'm just offering my opinion, Rick.
Which I didn't ask for.
But the mother did.
I'll come back.
You stay.
I have patience.
You know, we are going to pick this up later. Oh, and I have also called a meeting of the department heads so we can discuss the new CEO.
Right, well, I'll just tell all my patients that I'm busy in a meeting.
Another new CEO. This is getting to be a bit of a habit. Where do I sign?
Like you don't know.
Go.
All right, well. Not so fast. I gotta tell you, I'm not getting a very good feeling about this. You seem cut off.
You're gonna harvest one of my kidneys and implant it into the recipient.
Recipient? She's your mother. Look, I just have to ask you, are you sure that you wanna go through with this?
Yes. How many more times?
Hey, it's your birthday.
I don't do birthdays.
Of course. Well, you better head the birthday monitor off at the pass. She's back today.
Miss Naylor said she's very busy.
Did she scowl when you asked to go and speak to her mother?
Don't. You'll get me in trouble.
When she was a little girl, I always told her, wear a smile and you'll have friends. Wear a frown and you'll have wrinkles.
don't think you told her often enough.
There is something I need to say to her, though. You did tell her that.
I'm sure she'll... It's just...
Ask her again. Go on. Please.
Okay.
What is it?
I'm sorry.
You say that a lot.
Yeah. Your mother, Miss Burrow, she... I think there's something she wants to say to you.
Lord Jasper, you've entered my grave. I'm not Jasper. Into my grave.
You okay?
Where is Nurse Jackson?
No, she's not here yet. She...
Late, you mean? When she arrives, tell her to come see me immediately. I'll deal with her later.
Hey.
Oh, thanks.
Hey, stop him. Quick. Wait,
okay. No more, I can't. Left this in Texas.
Yeah. You had something you wanted to say?
Today, Jack. Today is such an important day to me. To both of us. It's momentous. Really. There aren't many mothers who share something so precious with their daughter.
Is that it?
Jack, please. My heart, it feels really heavy.
It's probably just guilt.
No, really. It's like a lead weight inside. Fear all the time. Could there be something wrong with the pacemaker? Something they missed? Please look at it.
I'm not allowed to. Even if I cared enough to be bothered, which I don't. And for your information, I don't do heart anymore.
Esther, the reason you're having difficulty is because you have fluid on your lungs. If you sit up, you'll breathe properly and the fluid will start to clear.
What seems to be the problem here?
You're not doing as you've been told, Mr. Hester. Come across men like you before. Did you? Want him sitting up, yeah? Hang on a second. Now, what I want you to do is hug this pillow, all right? Cuddle it, just like you're cuddling your sweetheart. Yeah? Nice and tight. So a big squeeze after three. Okay. One, two, three. There you go. Squeeze. Okay. We'll take that under. Okay. And then we'll take this. We'll put that there. There. Did you want to see me?
If you tell anyone it's my birthday, I will be your worst nightmare. Do I make myself clear?
My lips are sealed.
Now, I want you to completely dismantle and repack Mr. Hester's back dressing.
Okay.
Yes, it's purulent and very odorous. I want the cultures taken and the whole thing repacked with black PU foam and a new vac unit.
I think she's only got me in here so I'm not offering the hospital with a birthday card. Like anyone even cares. Do you think her mum's remembered her birthday?
I don't think Paula's even capable of remembering what day of the week it is.
Should we tell her? My mum was rubbish at remembering my birthday. I used to send myself a card just in case she forgot. Can you believe that? Yeah, I know. I suppose that's why I'm birthday monitor. I'm overcompensating. I mean, that can leave a big hole in a little girl's life, you know?
Yeah, I don't think Jack was ever a normal little girl.
Of course she is, you know? She's got normal feelings deep down, just like everyone else. It's just she's a master at keeping them hidden. She's very good at playing that old Frosty the Ice Queen, you know?
Do you want me to... It's weird wearing one of these, isn't it? I mean, I remember from when I was a patient. Hey, you feeling nervous?
No.
Told you.
Perfectly normal.
His father's a doctor.
She remembered?
Not a clue. Did you lose yourself again? Can we take you what's been said? Can we take you?
You can find yourself alone. kidney.
No, I wanted to say, don't mention it.
If it gets you out of my life, it'll be worth every...
Right, well, any of you ever doubted that Jack Naylor is made of human flesh and blood like the rest of us? There's proof. Oh, gosh, she's one of ours, so let's do a perfect job.
Please, 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 God, let my mommy be here.
That's the kidney. That's the Garota's fascia.
Blow out the candles. Blow out the candles. Make a wish.
Now this is keyhole surgery. That's the renal artery. Laparoscopic clips. Okay, tell Mr. Griffin in Theater 2 to Hepper and ice clamp and open up the vessel. Extracting. That, ladies and gentlemen, is one beautiful kidney. Okay, let's get that boxed up over to Theater 2. Let her know I'm on my way.
Ollie, look at his little pea suit.
It's so cute.
Oh, I hate it. He was dressed in 100% Egyptian cotton.
So why is he now in a...
Sasha's awful mother.
Is she a bit of a pain?
Oh, royal.
All right, how you doing? Is that not a beautiful organ?
Maybe so. But I'm not sure the recipient is ready for it.
Hey, never get involved between mothers and daughters, right?
Oh, that's not what I meant. She has just had a pacemaker fitted.
That's why we need to get on with it. Vascular clamp. It's like Cinderella's glass slipper.
Be peaceful. Are we losing some blood here?
Nope, looks totally clean. Push more fluids. All right, let's remove those clamps. Looking very good.
And he's got these two little girls.
Okay, it's all looking good here. How's the BP?
Very low. Pulse very high and rising.
Pacing wires? Could be a tamponade.
I did say that. I wasn't sure.
Yeah, I know what you said, Rick. Damn. All right, 100% oxygen, bagger, and start the inotropes.
Call for a CT surgeon.
All right, let's pace the on-call CT surgeon.
Let's get a chest open and get ready, please. Still in the air.
Carry on chest compressions.
Altruism can be one of them.
Joseph, what's happening to my mother?
Wouldn't that be the best revenge?
Leave me alone! I just want to be left alone. It's not my birthday. If you want to know what I wish for, I'll tell you. I wish the bitch was dead.
It's all right. Ms. Naylor, you're okay. You're okay, look. Here she is.
She's fine, Jack. She pulled through. But she did give us a scare there. The pacemaker guide wire made a puncture that bled into the pericardium.
She said...
Joseph had to run a pigtail catheter.
She said her heart felt heavy.
Yeah, that would have been the cavity filling up with blood.
I didn't listen. She tried to tell me something was wrong, and I just blanked her.
Jack's looking flat, could be bleeding, so let's give her 500 mils of Vulpex.
Okay, sure.
Okay. Rest, Jack. Mother's gonna be fine.
Maria, can you push my bed a bit closer? Don't try to speak. I'm here. Just rest now. Say it for later, Mum.
Happy birthday, darling.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jack. Happy birthday to you.
Look, I know you said specifically not to. I just thought...
Well, thank you, nurse. Well done. You organised a cake?
Yeah, of course.
Light your candles now. Make a wish.
Right, let's cut it up.
Yeah. Why did you let her take credit for the cake? She didn't ask
you. Because, true or not, it means a hell of a lot more to Miss Naylor coming from her mum than from me.